morning printing, Uncle AJ. I am used to having people here. Gonna be working on the self-portrait today. Doing the final pass on the print, and then we'll get into some hand finishing on these once they dry. But that's for another day. Yeah, we got music today. So here's where it's at right now. Ooh, phone's angry. So this is what it looks like. Sorry for the glare. So today I want to lay down the what's called the key plate, the final plate, usually black, but I think I'm going to play with that a little bit today. I've been enjoying not doing straight up black ink on things lately. Even on the gig posters, we've figured out a way to, instead of doing a straight black, we've been doing a very, very dark purple as our blacks lately. It's, I don't know, just more interesting. Black can sometimes be bland, I guess. So for this, I think I'm gonna try green. Theoretically, you know, we got a nice warm brown going on here. Red and green being complements should give us a nice dark, interesting color. In theory, morning Dad, in theory, that should look like something. What it looks like, I don't know, but let's find out.
Technical difficulties. What it looks like? Okay, go. There we go. Sorry, I'm trying to get Facebook up on the iPad over there so I can see comments and actually talk to you people and play the music at the same time. It's just... Anyways, let's see what straight green does. Again, a little bit of two-way dryer. Thank you. to a dryer and you can't really put it back in the can. It's just going to turn into this solid chunk. And when you get those little chunks in your ink, see, like, I got to pick these little guys out. Those get into your ink on the press. You get out to the plate. It's going to cause little issues in the print. So, here's the difference. Thank you. tunes. Change the view. So here's what the plate looks like. Did the carving on that yesterday. proving more difficult than I thought it would. I'm trying to see the comments. My clean hands.
Thank you.
fully over into the press, which is probably going to happen anyway at this point. You want to push this color further than what I actually want to print, because it's going to mix with all that ink on the rollers, and it's going to bring it back. You know, like, this is way lighter than what I want to put, because all that ink's on the press.
So you can see that top roller oscillates back and forth. That's why if you just let it sit like that for a while, it's gonna mix all the way. While that's happening, let's bring our called magnesium carbonate. Does is it stiffens the ink. So instead of the ink getting all goopy on the plate and filling in a lot of fine details, it'll stay stiff. you can see the color on the rollers is much lighter now than what we were dealing with before. That's more of what I'm looking for. And let's see, what's the best view for you guys? Back here.
We are going to trip the press, which means the carriage is going to go down, ink the plate, but not take an impression. So we're basically just putting that new color on the printing plate. It's going to take a couple of passes to get a true read on the color. Let's see what we're looking at. Still dark, but definitely better. Also kind of looking at my registration at this point. Looks like I come up just a little bit. Push the plate up a little bit on the press. Yeah, I like that color a lot. It's really nice. It's still not perfect. Left to right is pretty good, but
so all of this blocking and whatnot that you see on the top and the bottom, that's what's called furniture. All different sizes, wood, and when you get down to little tiny adjustments like this, it comes down to these lead slugs. And I'm just going to take one of these tiny little slivers of lead. We want the plate to go up. Take one from the top, put it on the bottom. All right, let's try that.
Good now, but I think we threw off our left to right. So there's two ways to deal with it. We can move the plate like we did with the up and down, or we can move the paper gauge and just shift the paper, which I think that's what I'm going to do. So can you see?
Yeah, you can see.
Okay. So the way this press does registration is what's called three-point registration. You see me working this, there's a pedal down here that lifts these grippers. That's where your paper goes. But if you look even closer, there's these little blocks. and they're adjustable. You can move them in and out, and that's going to adjust your up and down on the paper. With a sheet this size, you typically only want to hit two of these. It just makes life easier. So right now it's hitting this one and this one, furthest out. This is your third. This is the side to side. So when I'm putting the paper in, it's hitting here, here, and then it slides over and hits here. That way you know your paper is in the same exact spot every single time. So to make our adjustment, we want the paper to come this way, just a hair. What I'm looking at,
if you can see it, but see that slight brown halo around my head and even on the shadow there, that's what I'm trying to get rid of.
That's how I'm gauging my registration. So yeah, we want the paper to come this way. So to do that, we're gonna move our gauge just a little bit. And like everything in printmaking, sneak up on it. It's close. The plate actually has to come down a little. Screwed up on the bottom. I think we're crooked. I think the plate is crooked. This is very typical. We will usually go through quite a few proofs before we get everything dialed in. We have to do this for every single color. So, you know, this is a 4-color print. Most of my stuff is usually 7, 8, you know. Luckily, I ran a lot of proofs on them. Better. So not quite there, but definitely better. This color a little better. Very heavy right now. Let's go over here and make some more ink. Added some more white to it. Thank you. pretty over-inked at this point, but I like the color. I like the registration. And in order to get the ink back to where I want it to be, we're just gonna run a shitload of prints and strip ink off the press. That's kinda all you can do at this point. I cannot see your comments. Usually I have my laptop right here and I can see the comments as they come in. But I'm...
Dex, watch out!
I got the laptop going in the other room. Running the We Will Get By prints off of that. So that's kind of priority at the moment. Doing pretty good on those. About a third of the way through the edition already. Chipping away at it. Thank you to everyone that grabbed one. Appreciate that. So you can kind of see how it's getting a little blotchy here. We've stripped a fair amount of ink off. Because the plate itself is much smaller than the rollers and it's just hitting in the middle, you're going to be heavier on the sides because it's not laying down any ink there. So as I'm inking the press, I'm really just hitting the center section to keep everything nice and even. But I do like the color. I do like the registration. That means we are pretty much ready to rock and roll. That's a nice one. That's a nice one right there. So this whole stack is proofs. Normally, we do not run this many for an edition this small. But as I started them, I noticed a lot of these pieces of paper have this scallop ding in them. That unfortunately, I didn't catch until I was already pretty deep into the edition. But that's fine. Basically just running these as practice at this point. Each print kind of has its own rhythm as to, you know, how often you have to ink, how much ink you're putting down, where exactly on the rollers you're laying it down. Sort of find that rhythm, you can do your best to keep things consistent through the edition. Thank you. right, last group. Then it comes down to literally adding sheets of paper to get the registration just right. It looked good on the proofs, but sometimes when you go from proof to the actual edition, you know, things can shift. So I'm gonna add just two sheets of paper. Not an exact science, people. It can become very frustrating too. But we'll get it. Very nice on the top, but the bottom is a little off, which makes me think that it's possibly crooked. The plate, I mean, the bottom needs to come out this way a little. Sneaking up on it. I think at this point I'm going to stop messing with it. Thank you. press a slam like that every once in a while. It just is what it is. These old Vandercooks. Great printing presses, but they are known to have gremlins in their electrical systems. Every once in a while they get a little cranky. This is sort of the zen part. Just becomes sort of muscle memory. Mind tends to wander. Start thinking about other projects. Ideas. What's next on the drawing board? Believe it or not, I've been asked to do a sketch for some summer dates. I love their optimism. I really do. I hope it works out. So yeah, that's next on my project list is obviously wrapping up the We Will Get By and I do have another license break with that piece in the works too. Pretty psyched about that. Kind of itching to get that going again. Dexter is sounding the alarm. Go see what's up. Be right back. UPS man, delivering some paper. surprised they're still having you sign for some packages. Don the rubber gloves. Yeah, once these dry, I plan on doing a lot of hand finishing on it. What that means, I don't quite know yet. But I know like these spots up here, like back in my old studio, when I used to work out of the basement of my house, I had a little cork board back behind me, and that's where I would post up my color drawdowns for whatever I was working on. So the idea of leaving these blank was to come back in and, you know, individually make little different color drawdowns for each print. Which I still love that idea. I don't know, something about the stark white of it is sort of bothering me a little bit. So I don't know. Kind of thinking out loud here. Part of me is a little curious if I was to like stain the entire thing. You know, like a subtle, taking like a couple tea bags or something, making like a little tinted bag, dip each print and then let them dry. I used to do, back when I was doing a lot of lithography, there was a stuff called touche. You would mix it up with water and you would lay it on your plate or your stone, you would let it dry, and it would form these reticulation lines, and it just made this really cool, funky texture that I used to play with a lot. I'm almost wondering if I could get something like that going on these. I don't know. I think given all of our situations and you know, my situation here at the studio, it's giving me a lot of time to experiment and to play around with things, and that's something I've always wanted to sort of play around with. Another thing I've always wanted to play with is beeswax, believe it or not. I used to work at the University of Hartford for over a decade, and I was involved with the alumni stuff, variants, at the Hartford Art School, where I graduated from. This was years ago. So yeah, that's something I've always kind of been curious about playing with. I don't know if that would work per se on prints. Yeah, maybe somehow staining paper itself. I don't know. We'll see. These are pretty cool, though. Yeah, I think like if I did the staining right, it could almost give it sort of this feel of the wood veneers. Could be fun though. Damn, I'm hungry. It is lunchtime. Get through these last few variants, and then we're gonna call it lunch. I didn't know if this was gonna work. This plate is 11 years old. I really didn't know how it was gonna print. But it printed just fine. Carving was a little tough, but even that wasn't too bad. Linoleum gets brittle over time. You typically don't want to have your linoleum hanging around for that long. And it was definitely harder than I am used to carving, but overall, not too bad. Did cut myself yesterday. I don't know if you can see that or not, but still happens. Every once in a while, it still happens. Makes the hand sanitizer real fun. Grab lunch. How do I turn this around? I'm gonna go grab lunch. Hope this has been fun. Hey, Uncle AJ, signing off. Stay safe.